Denver could be on track for its deadliest year in a decade after an extremely violent week. 8 people killed since the beginning of the month. Denver 7's Liz Gilardi is talking with the chief and a gang prevention expert about what's driving this.
It's summer. Kids should be out playing or at camp, but many of those activities aren't happening or they've been scaled back due to the pandemic.
We only are allowed to do, 30 or 40 kids where we would have, double or triple that if it wasn't COVID, because we don't have the facilities inside to keep everyone social distance.
Jason McBride is with the Gang Rescue and Support Project. In the morning, he leads a summer camp, but in the evening, he's out driving around neighborhoods where there's been an increase in violence. On Monday, he was at a vigil in Montbello.
And as we're doing the vigil, there's another shooting and there's another murder in police and lights, and we're doing a vigil. And then there's another shooting, and it's just one of the things that I've never seen before.
In Denver, 8 people have been killed since the beginning of the month and 10 shot or stabbed. In Aurora, 9 people were killed in June, and police have investigated 3 homicides so far this month.
And it's hard to speculate as to the exact cause.
Denver Police Chief Paul Pazin says his department is looking at data to identify trends.
But also working with our community, we have asked our community to help us in this. We have asked faith-based leaders. We've asked mental health professionals.
McBride believes gang activity is playing a role, too.
With the way things are now and retaliatory things, because we have a shooting, but then we have retaliation. And then from that retaliation, it's just a circle or cycle.
And he's worried if things stay the same, the violence will continue. Liz Gilardi, Denver 7.